opportunity is actually on Facebook posting a picture of you talking to them. and it was really about connecting and having these wonderful memories. And I think the reason I actually remember those because I was present and I was there. And that's what we're trying to do with all of these Dead Zone diners. And even though they're popping up here with Dixie, you can create your own diner, you can create your own Dead Zone. And where you're actually connecting and reminding people here, I'm here, hello, I'm here. Like little Lisa. Little Lisa's our youngest customer. Lisa, don't worry about that cell phone thing. So today I'm going to do a summer chopped salad. I hope you've been enjoying the food there. The recipes are on dixie.com/deadzonediner. And I just want to put together a really quick dish that you can also do at home with whatever is available. I like to do really, I'm doing this now, okay?
Absolutely.
Okay, I can keep talking. The hat. Yes, that is key. So, these are all things that are at the farmer's market right now. We have peaches and tomatoes, which look so good. They smell so good. Alright, and then I have some corn, I've got some sugar snap peas, and I've got some croutons and just some lettuce. And then I'm going to make a buttermilk dressing, which we call white barbecue sauce. Anybody from Alabama?
Me.
Oh, you from Alabama? Yeah. What? Yeah. The chances!
Birmingham?
Yeah. Birmingham has a great food city, just have a moment, which is the next. Can you not stir?
I can stir.
Okay, I was going to say you can't stir. That would be unfortunate. Yeah, come on. Alright, so your wife does most of the cooking.
Yes.
Well, now you're going to do some.
Yes.
Thank you. Here, take this as my wet. Okay,
this. I know that. I bought all the utensils.
Okay, he buys all the utensils. Alright, so we're going to start with sour cream. And then you're going to mix in some mayonnaise. It's equal parts in there. That goes. And the characteristics of a white barbecue sauce. Actually, I'm going to give you a bigger bowl just so you can stir like you know.
I got
one. Yeah, stir like you know. And all that. So the And just in case you forget what happened, she can play the video back. You still are very well. Right now, we're going to put in some horseradish. This is prepared horseradish. You can find this in the refrigerator section of your refrigerator. On the grocery store. Okay? This is going to add a little bit of spice. Okay. Do you like it spicy?
I do.
Okay, we're going to add some cayenne pepper then. She makes everything spicy because she likes spicy. Now, do you like spicy, Mike?
I love spicy.
Okay, so we're going to do this for her. Okay, just a little black pepper. And I like that you're smiling while you're doing this. This is really important. Because if you're not in a good mood when you're cooking, the only thing you should make is a what? Reservation.
Good.
And then for that little bit of tang, whatever you are cooking with, even if you don't have a recipe, right now we have this cloying kind of fatty flavor. So we have the sour cream and we have the mayonnaise, but we need to cut through that fat. So we need acid, and what that's gonna be in this barbecue sauce, the white barbecue sauce we're dressing, is the vinegar. So we're gonna put in some apple cider vinegar. Okay. So let's taste. Let's see. Where's the straws? You see, it's nice and loose. Right? So when you make a vinaigrette, it should be a little straw. It should be acidic. It should be salty because when you're adding all of these other vegetables and water, it waters it down. Taste. Oh my God, that's kind of
got.
I know, it's good. I like the
spice,
so I'm good. I love it. Yes. All right. Yeah, that's good. Thank you. What's your name? Issa. Okay, that's Issa.
Yes.
So good to meet you.
Thank you,
friend. You got that all on tape? Well, yeah. All right, so we have our dressing. Thank you, Issa. Thank you. Beautiful dressing. That's it. So now we're going to cut up all cook out there. Yes, right? Because you're eating right when you took things like this. That's fine. Right. So we're gonna have peaches. They are so juicy. Whenever you are cutting up a fruit like mango or peaches, you know that it's ripe because it should actually glisten. You see that glistening? If it looks dry, it's not sweet. It ain't sweet. You cut into it, it looks like a little parched, like chalk, like a matte fingernail polish. Bring in something that's new and new. Okay, so cutting up your peaches. And I love fresh fruit with tomatoes. But the thing about the salad is that you don't have to have a plan when you go to the grocery store or the farmer's market. You get whatever's there. And 9 times out of 10, it will be just fine. Oh, I got that fine. You all can ask me questions if you have any while I'm sitting up here cutting and you're just watching me slave away making a dinner.
Did you sharpen beforehand?
Did I sharpen?
Sharpen. That is like a sharp knife.
Oh, it is so sharp, right?
Yeah.
A steak knife is a sharp knife. Okay, so we're going to cut these up and get them in there. And again, this tomato is glistening. You know, I know you all have had you've had a lack of rain. But the thing is, is when there is a drought, fruits like tomatoes and peaches actually are better. Because what happens is all of the, if you had a lot of rain, all the water would go into the fruit and it would be really watery. But what happens when there's no water, all the flavor gets concentrated in the tomatoes or in the peaches, which is probably, are you noticing that the tomatoes are really good this season?
How do you pick a good tomato?
How do you pick a good tomato? You should smell it. Okay, so here we have our salad, and there you go.